with their lives. They fought for freedom, they fought for what's right, and they kept our flag waving through perilous fights. Three colors of honor, three colors of glory, three colors of full truth and liberty. They're there to remind us what's worth fighting for. Freedom for me and for you. God bless the red, white, and blue. Oh, oh, God bless the red, white, and blue.
Good morning, Houston. Welcome to the 43rd original MLK Jr. Virtual Experience and Parade of Giving. I'm Cambrell Marshall, KPRC Channel 2, and I am very honored to be a part of this year's celebration of Martin Luther King Jr., who has been reimagined because of this ongoing pandemic. Today, we're answering Dr. King's call for a day of service with a parade of giving. A drive-through donation drop-off is being held right now in Houston's historic McGregor Park. Our neighbors throughout Houston are driving through the park to drop off much-needed supplies for people in need. It is my pleasure to be a part of this celebration as we honor the memory of Dr. King. I'd like to begin by acknowledging the partnership between the Black Heritage Society, Mayor Sylvester Turner, and our generous sponsors, Radio One, HTV, Houston Media Source, Timmy Chan's Restaurant, Sitco, Houston Society Change, Mosque 45, Carl's Original, and Gulfgate Dodge Chrysler Jeep and Ram, and HEB. Houston's original MLK Jr. Parade is rich with history. It really sets itself apart from other cities across the country. It was back in 1974 when the late Mr. Ovi Duncantel created and became founder and executive director of the Black Heritage Society. A few years later, on January 21st of 1978, Mr. Duncantel established the first ever Martin Luther King Jr. birthday parade celebration in the United States, right here in Houston, deeming itself the original parade. You should know that the father of Dr. King himself, a reverend, served as the parade's grand marshal. Since then, this parade has been sanctioned by the family of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. At this moment, I'd like to invite all of our friends joining us online to please stand for the presentation of colors presented by the Houston Police Department Honor Guard. The Pledge of Allegiance led by Mr. Lynn Pham, Senior Side Loader Operator with the City of Houston Solid Waste Department, and the National Anthem, followed by the Negro National Anthem, performed by recording artist Mr. David Michael Wyatt.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we held at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof to the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? And a home of the brave. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmony of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound out as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on till victory is won. Stony the road we trod, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the day that hope unborn had died. Yet with a steady beat have not our weary feet come to the place on which I find their sign. See, we have come over the way that the tears has been watered. We have come treading the path through the blood of the slaughtered. Out from the gloomy past till now we and at last, where the white gleam of our storm is cast.
Very big thank you to our Houston Police Department Combined Honor Guard, Lynn Pham, of course, the senior side loader operator of the City of Houston Solid Waste Department, and, of course, to David Michael Wyatt for that very, very inspiring performance of the Negro National Anthem. Please welcome now Rabbi Amy Weiss. She is the founder and executive director of the Houston-based nonprofit Undies for Everyone to offer a prayer of hope and peace during these very uncertain times.
Everyone that has lived through a hurricane or two knows the story of the person on the roof, their house is flooded, and they're praying to God, please save me, help me. Truck comes by, they turn it away, a helicopter and a boat that God has sent. The person dies and goes to heaven and says to God, why didn't you save me? And God says, I sent you a truck, a helicopter, and a boat. The message being that we must be open to subtle and not so subtle signs from God. Martin Luther King said, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. Martin Luther King reminds us that we must save ourselves in the face of adversity, that while God is our strength and by our side, in the end, it's our own courage that moves us forward to the world in which we long to live, a world of equity, fairness, and justice. The phrase, be strong and of good courage, appears 29 times in the Hebrew Bible. The first time is when the Israelites are on the verge of going into Canaan. Moses is about to die and is passing the mantle of leadership to Joshua. Be strong and of good courage, Moses says to Joshua, knowing that the challenges will be daunting. Each time be strong and be of good courage appears in the text, it seeks to calm our doubts and fears in the face of adversity. Today is the day that we remember the man who heard the words, be strong and of good courage, and move the world to a better place. Today is the day that we take up the mantle to continue Martin Luther King's work for equity, fairness, and justice. Today is the day we take the words to heart, be strong and of good courage, praying for God to be with us on this journey.
Thank you very much, Rabbi Weiss. Now, it is a privilege for me to introduce our first speaker and co-grand marshal, Mayor Sylvester Turner. I'd like to commend him for his unwavering leadership and love for the city of Houston. Being the CEO of the fourth largest city is certainly not a cakewalk. Certainly, it's a big company to run. However, you add in the mix a few historic floods, a hurricane or three, and a global health crisis, and that would challenge the greatest of leaders. Yet every day, and through every crisis thrown at him, this mayor has been the most consistent and trusted voice in Houston, always giving, always thinking of others, and never losing hope for a more prosperous and unified future for all Houstonians. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the mayor of our great city, Mayor Sylvester Turner.
Thank you, Cambrill. And it's an honor and a privilege to serve as co-grand marshal this year, alongside Honorable Judge Lena Hidalgo. So much has changed for us over the past 10 months as we have battled a global pandemic. I know we would all prefer to be gathered personally, but it's just not safe. I am grateful for the ability, though, to celebrate the life and legacy of Dr. King in this virtual experience with you today. Dr. King preached that when an injustice is done to one of us, it is an injustice done to all of us. Today's virtual experience theme is Truth, Love, and Justice, a nod to the history of the Black Heritage Society and the country's current reckoning with race and systemic oppression. Dr. King stood for justice and equality. He once said, life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? Today, you may step up for others by donating to the drive-through donations being held at McGregor Park right now in support of your fellow neighbors who have been affected by the pandemic. Your generous contributions will allow two beneficiary organizations to organize and distribute the donated items to individuals with the greatest needs. Dr. King reminded us that we have a responsibility to each other and that in standing together, we can make a difference for our brothers and sisters. Better days are ahead of us, and my wish for you on this day is that you take comfort and inspiration from the lessons of Dr. King. Thank you, and enjoy today's celebration.
Thank you very much, Mayor Turner. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce our co-grand marshal for this year's parade. She has also exemplified extraordinary leadership during these very uncertain times. We are honored that she is participating in today's historic celebration with these important words of encouragement, Please welcome the Honorable Judge Lena Hidalgo.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. often spoke about racism and violence. If he were here today, he perhaps would be saddened by the persistence of institutional racism. He would be saddened by the black lives lost this year. On May 25th, 2020, a native Houstonian from the Third Ward who wanted to build a home for his mom, who wanted to change the world, was murdered by a Minneapolis police officer. George Floyd lost his life and incited a movement worldwide. And he reminded us, his death reminded us, that this is a time for agitation and that this is a time for action. We've been working hard in Harris County on misdemeanor bail reform to basically end the debtor's prison that has existed in this county when it comes to misdemeanor bail, and we continue to fight for that. We've also been working to invest in families and children rather than lock kids up at our juvenile detention facility. We've worked to invest in defense for folks who can't afford representation when they're accused of a crime, doubling the budget of our public defender's office, working to make sure that attorneys are appointed in a smart way. We've created a whole new division, the Justice Administration Department, to look at data and help us make decisions on criminal justice policy based on that. And we've dramatically expanded voting access because we believe that attention in government is what leads to positive change. And it's what so many people like Dr. King fought for. We're going to continue doing that, and we have to continue acting, but we also honor his legacy by getting together, even if it's virtually, like we're doing today, by celebrating what he stood for. And that's why I want to thank you guys for inviting me and allowing me the privilege of being the co-grand marshal this year, and for making this happen, even with a pandemic. It is an honor to join you all virtually, and it will be an honor to continue fighting alongside you.
Thank you very much, Judge Hidalgo. Please, now at this time, help me welcome to the stage the director of the Black Heritage Society, Mr. Sylvester Brown.
Thank you. I want to thank our Grand Marshals. Thank them for their leadership, specifically during these uncertain times. Next, I'd like to also thank our sponsors, who has been a part of our organization for some years. That would include HEB, Radio One, HTV, Houston Media Source, Timmy Chan's Restaurant, CITGO, Houston Society of Change, Moss 45, last but not least, Gulf Gate, Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, and Ram. We appreciate everyone who has given today to support these times of need, specifically that the World's Youth Foundation and St. John's Downtown, who are charities. We look forward and we can't wait to next year to see everyone in person. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Brown, and the Black Heritage Society for producing this wonderful opportunity to celebrate virtually. And we wouldn't be here without your vision to carry out the Dr. King's message that is still so important today. Ladies and gentlemen, the annual Foley and Lardner MLK Jr. Oratory Competition is hosted each January in conjunction with Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day to encourage the community to remember and pay tribute to the late civil rights leader's legacy. Presented in the spirit of learning and celebration, the annual Foley and Lardner MLK Jr. Oratory Competition invites fourth and fifth grade students to write and present a short original speech that envisions Dr. King's message to today's world. This year, the students answer the question, how do you think Dr. King's teachings can help us today? Here to close out today's ceremony, I'd like to introduce this year's remarkable winner, as they recite the winning speech.
I walked into my Bible study class on a Wednesday night wearing my favorite red fluffy dress with black polka dots, my white ballet slippers, with two pigtails and my butterfly hair clips. Greeted by my teacher with a pat on my back, Miss G asked us girls to link hands as we were going to pray. But I noticed the girl next to me didn't want to hold my hand. I asked what was wrong. She claimed with a repelled look on her face that I was dirty because I was brown. We were only six at the time. I kept myself together and waited for my mother to pick me up. When she arrived, I grabbed her hand and told her what had happened. At 6 years old, I thought it was my fault, but my mother reassured me that it wasn't my fault and the little girl didn't know any better. I could hear Dr. King whispering to me, "I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they are not judged by the color of their skin but by the content of their character." My character should not be judged by the color of my skin. You should call someone a friend because they are trustworthy and kind. I choose to be colorblind. I'd rather be colorblind than let the color of another person's skin get in the way of meeting my best friend. Dr. King said it best. If we do not learn to live together as friends, we die as fools. This summer, my mother turned on the news. I was so surprised at what was going on. First, we heard about George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, and Vanessa Guillen. On top of that, we are in the midst of a worldwide pandemic that has caused thousands of deaths and continues to do so as of today. Day after day, night after night, protest after protest, it would seem like a war all across America with fires and raids. I was afraid. I shouldn't feel afraid and unsafe in my own country. I then heard Dr. King reminding me, we must build dikes of courage to hold back the flood of fear. So I say to you, do not let the troubles of this world cause you to stumble, but press on. Press on and do not be afraid. I've had time to reflect on how Dr. King's words contain the trials and tribulations that people are experiencing today. I can hear his words ringing in my ear. He would say that hate begets hate. Violence begets violence. Toughness begets greater toughness. We must meet the forces of hate with the power of love. Dr. King always preached on the power of love. If we had love, there would not be hate or violence in the world. He would say that darkness cannot drive out darkness, for only light can do that. We would solve issues peacefully, remembering that we are only human. Dr. King's words would challenge us not to judge each other by the color of our skin, but by the content of our character. These words held the truth and still hold the truth today. My final thought and strong belief agrees with Dr. King when he said, "The time is always right to do what is right." Thank you.
Again, I'd like to thank Mayor Turner and Judge Hidalgo for being our co-grand marshals, the Black Heritage Society, HTV, the Mayor's Office of Special Events, our amazing sponsors, and all of our program participants for this beautiful ceremony today. I invite you to stay connected online or on HTV and enjoy this virtual experience. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Matthew.
And I'm Zainab.
On June 2nd, 2020, we participated in the Rally for Peace for George Floyd. We witnessed Houstonians from all walks of life take to the streets and march in the name of peace and against racial injustice.
As filmmakers, what we realized was that we were not only documenting the events, but we also found ourselves as willing participants fighting for a cause that we believe so strongly in.
The film you're about to watch, titled Peace for George Floyd, is a culmination of the events that took place that day when thousands of Houstonians took to the streets and marched for peace and justice for the lives of George Floyd and countless others who have lost their lives to racial injustice.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, An injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere.
We hope this film continues a conversation where inequality still exists in our society.
That justice and equality needs to be realized by all men and women, and we will march until we see that change.
They are calling for an end to racism and police violence.
Y'all heard the phrase blood, sweat, and tears. We're gonna sweat today. We're gonna shed tears today. But we're not gonna drop a drop of blood in Houston, Texas today. No pain and no violence today.
No peace! No peace!
I want to say this, my heart goes out to every single city, state that's losing people, that's lost people, or that's in the process of even fighting and feel like their situation is swept under the rug. We don't know all the situations. We learn about them as time goes by, and we're going to just keep doing what we can. We're not only going to fight for George Floyd, because he's in Houston, we're going to fight for everybody.
For far too long, Nike shoes and polo drawers, I mean, back to Jim Crow laws. Back to when my ancestors would have rather drown than suffer in their own chains, feces, and blood. Because death was more promising than slavery and cotton crops. Blood drops from those same fingers pricked over and over. The same blood that drops from the lacerations on those black backs. The blood that runs through my veins is the same blood that can never be replaced.
They want to catch you on camera, throwing a brick, turning over a car, burning down a building, so that they can justify murdering us. But we don't have to throw one brick. What we have to do is organize. Organize our people, register to vote, and turn out like we have never turned out before.
Time of prayer. In the memory of George Floyd. Right now, we're getting ready to go to the throne of grace and mercy. And I'm gonna ask you, if you don't mind, to go ahead and focus in that God would lead us in this moment and in this time.
Amen.
This is a sacred time for the body of Christ. This is the sacred time for the city of Houston. And we are Houston proud, 100%. So if you don't mind, no matter where you are, would you bow with us?
Something that resonated in my mind over and over again. And that is, unless we stand up, unless we do more, that memorial will continue to grow. But we cannot forget. We say their names because we do not want to forget the lives that have been lost because of racial and social injustice.
And go home to my Lord.
my grandmother one day. I said, "Grandmother, have you ever been a slave?" My grandmother took me on the side. She whispered in my ear, she said, "Why, hell yeah, hell yeah. 400 years, 400 years. Well, I've been hog-tied, dog-tongued. I've been shot down by the sound of a gun. Bull-whipped, I've been back-stripped. I've been laid down on a sailor ship. Sunburned, back's torn. I've been working shanked in the early morning. And looked at coal black. I've been ran down by a nasty track. And you ask me, is it true? Why, hell yeah. 400 years, 400 years. Slave and labor, white man's favor. Work plantation and build white nation. Call me Charlie, work and wallah. And you ask me, is it true? Why, hell yeah, hell yeah. 400 years, 400 years. Then I asked my grandfather, real cool dude, out of sight, Cadillac with a built-in maid, big old pad. So look here, grandfather, have you ever been a slave? My grandfather took me on the side, and he whispered in my ear, he said, "Why, hell yeah." I said, "Hell yeah, 400 years, 400 years, 400 years. Well, I've been hog-tied, dog-tongued. I've been shot down by the sound of a gun. Bull-whipped, I've been back-stripped. I've been laid down on a sailor ship. Sunburned, back's torn. I've been working chains in the early morning. And look at coal black. I've been ran down by a nasty track. And you ask me, is it true? Hell yeah, hell yeah. 400 years, 400 years. Help me break these chains, brother. Help me break these chains, sister. Help me break these chains. Gotta break these chains.
That grace founded on two-thirds a person. Rapings and beatings and suffering that worsens. Black human packages tied up in strings. Black rage can come from all these kinds of things. Black rage is founded on blatant denial, squeezed economics, subsistence survival, deafening silence and social control. Black rage is founded on wounds in the soul. When the dogs bite, when the bees sting, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember all these kinds of things, and then I don't fear so bad. Black rage is founded, fed us self-hatred, lies and abuse while we waited and waited. Spiritual treason, this grid and its cages. Black rage is founded on these kinds of things. Black rage is founded on training and training, finding your freedom to stop your complaining, poisoning your water while they say it's raining. Call you mad for complaining, complaining. Progress, such human contortion. Black rage is founded on these kinds of things. When the dogs bite, when the beating, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember all these kinds of things, and then I don't fear so. Oh,
From the day I first met you, your promises proved to be untrue. So step by step, I've been a fool. Now I'm just two steps from the blue. The reason we didn't get along was telegrams and telephone. One bring bad news, the other rendezvous, that keeps me two steps from the blues. Here's a chance to be loved or be lonely. My heart awaits.
Good morning, Houston. I am Paige Hubbard, and I am so happy to be here with you on this marvelous Monday as your host for the Parade of Giving. Now, we are all gathered here today to celebrate and honor the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and his National Day of Service. Right now, I would like to bring in Mayor Sylvester Turner, the Grand Marshal of this wonderful parade. How you doing today, Mayor?
Hey, Paige, I'm excited. Look, I'm feeling good. This is MLK Day. Happy MLK Day. And look, even with the pandemic, the celebration doesn't stop.
Absolutely, Mayor. I think that's a great point to make. The pandemic has changed so many things, but it's not going to stop our mission to help those in need.
Absolutely.
As the mayor, can we talk about the importance of giving back and supporting those in need?
Well, quite frankly, you know, we are strengthened when we support one another. There are a lot of people, for example, who are in need, especially over the last 12 months with this pandemic. And the best thing that we can do to assist is to help them to get on their feet. You know, people are find themselves in this situation not because of their own being, but this pandemic has really been destructive to so many families. So I think we all benefit when we give what we have, when we share what we have with somebody else. That's what Dr. Martin Luther King would have wanted. And so it cannot be a better way of celebrating his life, his legacy, than to have this be a day of giving.
Absolutely. Now, you know, we're out here accepting donations.
Yes.
For the World Youth Foundation and the Bread of Life Incorporated. But what are some other ways folks can get involved if they want to do their part and give back?
Well, I mean, the reality is that check on your neighbors. Check on the seniors who are right around you. There are people, for example, who have lost their jobs, people who are trying to feed their families. And you'll be surprised, the little that you can do can be big in somebody else's life. So you don't have to have a whole lot to be beneficial. And oftentimes the people who need the help are the people who are right around you.
I think that's a good point to make. Most of the times people think it's, you know, giving money or, you know, it's all about volunteering. Maybe going to help out at your local soup kitchen or, as you said, helping a neighbor in need, maybe somebody that's elderly.
I tell you something else, you know,
in a time when we're telling people to be physically separated, just picking up the phone and contacting somebody to say, just how you doing? You know, I thought about you. I just wanted to let you know that I'm thinking about you, love you. If you need something, you let me know. That phone call literally can make a difference. There's a lot of stress, a lot of anxiety in the lives of so many people. Loneliness, okay? We're just not built to be separate and apart. But because we're physically separated, doesn't mean we can't still be connected. So take the time to reach out to somebody that you know, and sometimes even that you don't know, and just put in a good word. You know, just encourage people.
Absolutely.
Will make a difference.
A little loving can go a long way these days with everything going on, you know.
Even the mayor needs that.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
I tell you,
well, Mayor Turner, as this is MLK Day, our last question, what do you remember MLK's legacy as?
Look, someone who led with boldness, someone who really emphasized that it's never the wrong time to do the right thing. Stand up against wrong, stand up against evil, because let me tell you, if you allow a wrong to get situated, and if you don't try to root it out, it's like a cancer that grows. And so this was someone who made a change, made it in a very nonviolent way, but a profound change that all of us are benefiting from today. And then the other thing that I remember is that regardless of your situation, you can still dream.
Absolutely,
and then
Mayor.
When you stop dreaming, you got to get up to make it a reality.
Absolutely. Very well said. They are wrapping us up, so I think that's all the time we have for right now. I want to thank you for your time, and it's always a pleasure to see you. Thank you all for tuning in. Again, we are out here at McGregor Park making it happen on the National Day of Service. We're going to send it back to J-Mac and Keisha Nicole and check back in you all with, in a little bit.
It was almost 12 years after the assassination of Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. People all over the nation who supported his nonviolent protest and the civil rights movement missed the peaceful freedom marches, although some of the participants were brutalized by law enforcement officers and citizens who objected to the nonviolent surge for civil rights advocated by Dr. King. The cause that once resembled a green, strong, leafy shade tree of hope and dreams of freedom and equality had been reduced to a dry log of despair. Only a remnant of the quest for freedom that engulfed the freedom marches of the 1960s. Then it happened. In 1975, the Black Heritage Society of Houston, Texas, launched a bold initiative. They endeavored to rename one of Houston's major thoroughfares, the South Park Boulevard, as Martin Luther King, MLK Jr. Boulevard. This initiative was widely supported nationwide because it strengthened efforts at the congressional level to enact legislation that recognized a Martin Luther King Jr. holiday.
Welcome to the 43rd annual MLK Day Virtual Experience and Parade of Giving. Thank you, Ms. Helen Johnson, for that beautiful history lesson. So much has happened in this great city through the years. And thank you to our Mayor, Sylvester Turner, and Judge Odago for kicking things off. Thank you for your service. We are so proud of our city and grateful for how you both led us through some of the most challenging past few years. Thank you. I'm Keisha Nicole.
And I'm J-Mac. And on behalf of the Radio 1 Houston team, I'd like to thank you for watching today. This year makes 43 years of celebrating the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. And we're proud to join once again as the official media partner. This historic parade was the very first MLK Day parade held in the nation, after being sanctioned by the King family in 1978 here in Houston. Last year, the Black Heritage Society and the City of Houston made the decision to bring a virtual parade experience to you despite the current conditions. They knew that especially now, we all need to come together as one, celebrating our history and great accomplishments throughout the years.
Today, you'll see throwback clips from past parades, local bands, civic groups, and the Parade of Giving happening at McGregor Park, where donations are being dropped off right now in honor of this day of service. So please share it with your friends so they can watch too, and use the hashtag #OriginalMLKParade on social media. Now let's get started with a look back at the very first parade in 1978 with our very own Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee. We'll also see a performance by Fur High School cheerleaders, Worthing High School band, dance, and cheer, past footage of TSU's Ocean of Soul, and much more.
Hello, I'm Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee, and I represent the historic 18th Congressional District, which was actually created after the 1965 Voting Rights Act was passed. And of course, the first holder of this seat was the Honorable Barbara Jordan. Dr. Martin Luther King walked across the Edmund Pettus Bridge and demanded on behalf of Negroes in America that we had the right to vote. Shortly, of course, alongside of him was John Robert Lewis, who likewise was beaten on the Edmund Pettus Bridge, and together their voices raised that we must have the right to vote. But even before that, Rosa Parks sat down on a bus so that Jesse Jackson might run and that we might win. All tied to Dr. Martin Luther King. I'm excited of being part of the 43rd original Martin Luther King Parade, and of course, the virtual experience Day of Giving, Day of Caring. And now, as we begin, I'm excited about this 43rd original Martin Luther King Parade in its virtual form, and also excited about the wonderful history of this parade, which is the fact that Dr. Martin Luther King's daddy gave this commissioned right to Ovid Duncantown to ensure that we were able to have a parade in 1978. Yes, Daddy King gave this opportunity experience to our friend Ovid Duncantown in 1978, 5 years before the Martin Luther King holiday was created as a national federal holiday. And Ovid Duncantown has led this parade for decades. He was the founder, he was the visionary, and he kept it going. How excited I am to have opportunity to work for and to work with Ovid Duncantown, to work with the Black Heritage Society and the great work it has done. It is not just an organization that promotes parades, but under Ovid Duncantown and its leader coming forward, it always fought for justice. How exciting it is for us to be part of this outstanding effort and to work with Ovid Duncantown over the years to be able to maintain this parade and maintain the fight for justice. We're excited about being part of the 43rd original Martin Luther King Day Parade.
Thank you. Hello, I am Marilyn Burgess, your Harris County District Clerk. I feel honored to speak to you today as we commemorate the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. It is important to remember his remarkable life story, as well as the stories of countless others who dedicated their lives to fight for the advancement of civil and human rights for everyone in our country. I would like to share a historical fact with you. In 1960, Dr. King experienced firsthand the power of a jury ruling when he was acquitted in the case about his alleged underpayment of state income taxes. That acquittal was quintessential in Dr. King's life. If he had been declared guilty, he could have been sentenced to prison and wouldn't have been able to actively lead the civil rights movement. At the time, the acquittal was somewhat surprising because of the makeup of the jury. But it proved that the United States has a justice system that can serve us all with fairness. However, the system certainly isn't perfect. Given that summonsing jurors and coordinating jury service is one of my primary responsibilities as district clerk, my team and I are working to increase the representation of African Americans and other minorities on our Harris County juries. Fair outcomes should be a norm, not a surprise, and diverse juries can make the difference. My administration has conducted a comprehensive survey to hear from citizens how best to increase jury participation as a whole, and in particular with minorities. I am committed to making our juries more diverse, but it takes the strength of the whole community to see the desired change. I ask you to help me make Harris County a shining example for our country. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of the parade.
Hey! When I was growing up in Sunnyside, I got to witness the power of Martin Luther King Jr. and the brave young men and women who were part of the Civil Rights Movement. Hearing his speeches and seeing the March on Washington had a big impact on me and my initial decision to enter public service. Today, we may not be able to gather in the streets to celebrate Dr. King, but I hope that all of us across the country will still use this day to reflect on the legacy of Dr. King and think about what it means to truly honor his life's work. Because in many ways, this work is still not done. Many of us wish that the issues that Dr. King raised, including racial inequality, economic justice, and fairness under the law, were behind us, but they're not. The truth is that we're still very much in this fight and dealing with many of the same challenges that he dealt with during his lifetime. Today, many will quote Dr. King's speeches and his words, but the true reason we honor Dr. Martin Luther King is because of his willingness to stand up and fight for equality and justice for all. And we can only honor his legacy by embodying that same spirit. At this time of great unrest and incredible challenges facing every one of us, we must go beyond words and respond with meaningful action. We've come very far since the day Dr. King marched on Washington, and I believe that together we can achieve that nation he dreamed of. Together we can continue the work of Dr. King by pushing for systemic change. We can enact bold solutions that provide true racial equality. Happy Martin Luther King Day to every one of you.
Good morning, Houston. I am Paige Hubbard, your host for the Parade of Giving. I am so happy to be out here with you all on this marvelous Monday morning as we celebrate and honor the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and the Day of Service. Okay, and so right now we're out here at Martin Luther King celebration at McGregor Park, and today is all about service. The MLK Day Service Initiative is about inspiring and encouraging Americans to give back to their communities. And that's exactly what we have going down here at McGregor Park today. We're collecting donations for two charitable organizations. One, the Bread of Life Incorporated, and the second is the World Youth Foundation. But before we get to them, we want to bring in the executive director from the Bread of Life Incorporated. The executive director is Mr. Johnny Jones. How you doing this morning?
I'm doing well. Good morning. Thank you so much, Paige, for having us here.
Absolutely. Now, tell us a little bit more about your organization.
Sure thing. So, Bread of Life was founded in 1992 by Pastors Rudy and Juanita Rasmus with a simple mission to serve men and women who are experiencing homelessness in the downtown region. Fast forward to 28 years later, our mission is still focused on supporting underserved communities and restoring hope in the Houston area. We do that through four programs: homeless outreach, hunger relief, health outcomes, and our amazing radio station, the KMAZ 102.5.
Absolutely. It's such a blessing to be a blessing.
Yes. Certainly.
So tell us some of the donations that you all are collecting today.
So we're collecting diapers, toothbrush, toothpaste, deodorant, hygiene items, items that we particularly give out and provide to families that we support. As you can see behind us, we have, I call them the Houston version of Rolling Thunder coming through to make donations. And you can see our big box truck right behind us where we're collecting donations. And we are just so grateful and thankful for all of the many folks that are donating today through the Parade of Giving because we couldn't do it without your support.
Absolutely. It takes a village, and it's definitely a collaborative effort to get everything done here today.
That's correct.
Now, let's talk about the folks who can't make it here in person. How can they still help give back to the Bread of Life?
That's a great question. So wherever you are, you can go to our website, breadoflifeinc.org, and there you can sign up for one of our many volunteer opportunities, either in person or virtually. You can also go and donate. We can't do this by ourselves, and so we will appreciate your support. Secondly, right from the comfort of your cell phone, text the word Give Bread of Life to 77 77977. Again, that is Give Bread of Life to 77977. Because as I said, we can't do this by ourselves, but together we can make a difference.
Absolutely. It takes a village to raise a child and a community. Yeah. Now we're out here talking to each other, socially distanced, standing 6 feet apart. There's so much going on in the world right now as we're out here honoring Martin Luther King. Can you just tell us, how do you feel like his legacy should be remembered?
I think what we're doing right now is emphasizing his legacy, giving back to those who are in need, but looking at your brother and your sister as someone that deserves to be viewed as an individual, right? I think when we begin to dehumanize each other, that's when the strife, the hatred comes into play. But at Bread of Life, we believe in expressing love and preserving one's dignity, regardless of your state in life.
Very well said. I think that's all the time that we have, so we're going to end it right here and send it back to J-Mac and Keisha Nicole in their studio.
Wow, it's so good to see so many people giving back. This year's theme is truth, love, and justice, and we're so proud to see so many people committed to these values. We know that now more than ever, we must use our voice for change. Shout out to the nonprofit partners for this year's parade, St. John's Downtown, and the World Youth Foundation. Thank you for all you do to serve the community.
Now, Keisha, you know I love to see us coming together.
You know I do too, J-Mac. Now, coming up,
you'll see Booker T. Washington's ROTC and Dance, Houston Symphony Community Embedded Musicians, along with Metro and more throwback
footage. Yes!
Like most fathers who love their children, Reverend Martin Luther King Sr. never forgot how badly his son was treated in Houston. So, when the Daniel brothers invited him to join them and the Black Heritage Society in an attempt to encourage the city of Houston to make his son's life and legendary works an annual event, he was thrilled to accept the invitation. His enthusiasm and gratitude mingled with the determination of the Martin Luther King Jr. Street Naming Project, spearheaded by the Daniel Brothers and the Black Heritage Society, propelled the communities to action, and South Park Boulevard was renamed Martin Luther King MLK Jr. Boulevard. The esprit de corps, dedication, and commitment from this group of Houstonians who dared to rename a street to immortalize the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. created a spark of community spirit that ignited the annual Martin Luther King parades. Actually, it was the first major parade and street change ceremony in America. This historic event occurred on January 21, 1978. We are fortunate to have one of the key players in that historic event of 1978. He is none other than Ovid Duncantel, Executive Director of the Black Heritage Society. Mr. Duncantel will narrate some of the historical facts for us.
That day was a memorable day because of the inclement weather. It was somewhere between 9 and 19 degrees above zero. I can remember that much. However, we had 20 bands were scheduled to be in that event for that parade. The weather would not cooperate. All the bands were canceled. We only had 3 bands to show, and they walked to the parade because they were area bands. That was Jones High School, and that was Worthing and Sterling. We made a parade out of that, but fortunately we had 600 cars that lined up for this parade. And matter of fact, they were all the way down at the end of Martin Luther King Boulevard, and cars were still coming, getting in line.
Hello everyone, my name is Rainel Joubert, and my colleague's name is David Connor. We are both community embedded musicians with the Houston Symphony, and we're very glad and thrilled to be sharing some music with you for the 43rd annual Martin Luther King Day Parade. The song we have selected is called Will the Circle Be Unbroken, composed by Ada R. Harberson and arranged by our own David Conner. I really hope you guys enjoy as much as we did recording this song.
Taylor behind the wheel is not only just the bus operator, the mother to the children that comes aboard, the compassionate one to my elderly customers, passengers. My name is Audrey Taylor. I've been a Metro bus operator for the last 14 years. My passengers are very important to me because without them, there's no me. Your passenger, we all become family. We get to know each other sometimes when we can. And when it's time for us to change running, it becomes a little emotional. One time I had an incident where it was a regular route. They felt comfortable and I felt comfortable with them, and we just became a big Metro family. I didn't know that the passengers had planned a party for me, a going away party. It was so overwhelming because I didn't realize that I meant that much to them.
At Metro, we believe in helping people. We're partnering with the City of Houston, Walmart, Sam's, and the Houston Food Bank to deliver groceries to people in need.
We started early this morning staging across the street, and what we've been able to do is get at least 60 of our vehicles out here, our yellow cab and first transit vehicles, to actually help the community in delivering groceries. So it's a pretty big operation, probably over 600 customers that we'll be able to serve today. We're working with the mayor's office with persons with disabilities, and we've got those lists from them, from the city. And then what we're able to do is utilize the scheduling system that we have here at Metro to actually schedule those trips onto Manifest.
We're excited about the opportunity. We know that it's a challenging time for the entire nation.
It's just a really great experience and a really great way to actually show the community how much we care about them.
Hi, everybody. Adrian Garcia, County Commissioner of Precinct 2. On this day of service, we not only celebrate the life, legacy, and work of Dr. Martin Luther King, but we celebrate all of what those achievements signify for our society, for our community, for our county, our state, and our country, and even beyond. He fought for a dream of truth, of love and justice, the truth to be who you are as you are, the love that unites communities, and a fight for racial justice and equality. This celebration may look and feel a little different this year, but the fight for a better tomorrow and the strength of our communities remains the same, if not stronger. We are all in it together, make no mistake of that. And together, we can get through this pandemic and any other challenge that may confront our communities and our societies. We can do it together. I am confident of that. Dr. King gave us an example to follow, and we should work to follow it every single day. On behalf of my family, on behalf of all of Precinct 2 in Harris County, I want to wish you and your families a happy MLK Day. Thank you very much.
Hi, everybody. I'm Sally Alcorn. I'm the at-large council member, and I'm down here at the MLK Day of Giving because we need to help out our neighbors. This has been an exceptionally tough year for so many people, so what a great way to celebrate the legacy of MLK by giving basic essentials to our neighbors in need. So come on down to McGregor Park and help us out. Thanks.
Alrighty, welcome back, H-Town. It's Paige Hubbard here, and we are still out here at McGregor Park celebrating the Parade of Giving as we're collecting donations for charitable organizations. I have the chairman, the chief executive officer, and the founder of one of those organizations, Mrs. Karen Franklin, with the World Youth Foundation. Good morning. How's it going?
Good morning, Paige. It is a glorious day today, and
it certainly
is. We are
so
honored to be here with the city and the Bread of Life, continuing our efforts in serving our community.
Absolutely. As I said, you're the chairman, the chief executive officer, and the founder. You wear so many hats. Tell us, what do you do with the organization?
Yes, Paige, and thank you for asking. We are at the end of our 30th year in being a life development incubator. We teach kids how to learn, live, and grow while they're achieving their next step in life. Through this pandemic and the challenges that are before us, we ensure that our students from 6 to 24 have a definitive voice. And more particularly, we make sure we move them beyond testing. And within this space, we also ensure that service learning is applied. So today we're collecting non-perishable goods so that we can continue to cover families in its totality.
And so what was the importance of collecting some of those goods to give back during a time when so many folks are in need and hurting from this pandemic?
Yes, the importance of it, Paige, we deliver to families 365 perishable food. And in our efforts through our Joy of Giving program, we see such the need is more than what we can ever imagine. So because we are delivering, we want to make sure we can cover them in all areas that are needed while we continually to teach our kids.
Absolutely. Touching all bases across the board.
Absolutely.
I see.
Very holistic is our organization.
All right.
Yes.
Now they're wrapping us up. The one last question for you. We're out here also today to remember and honor Martin Luther King Jr.
Absolutely.
So what does his legacy mean to you?
The legacy means to us is we can't do anything without extending to those that we don't know and those that we do know to help the most vulnerable of our communities. And that is what is being demonstrated here today with the Black Heritage Society and the City of Houston.
Very well said, Mrs. Franklin. Thank you for your time today and all your contributions to our society here in H-Town. That's all the time that we have for right now, folks. We're going to once again send it back to J-Mac and Keisha Nicole.
Thank you.
Welcome back. I just want to say thank you to Ms. Audrey Taylor at Metro, and thank you to all the frontline workers who continue to sacrifice, going above and beyond for others. We appreciate you. But before we move in to the next block, J-Mac, I got to ask you, man, what do you miss most about parades?
Of course I miss the big floats. When I was a kid, the float
was the thing. You know why? Because we saw them coming all the way from down the street. Yeah. So I love the floats. What about you, Keisha?
I mean, I do love the floats too, but I think I love most just getting up with my family earlier that morning to watch the parade and for other people to learn about our culture and what, you know, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. really stood for.
Okay. Now let's take it back with more footage from past parades, including Jackie Yates. We also hear from the Salvation Army and the Houston Kappa League.
Well, certainly it had to be with Ovi Duncantel reaching out to me as a young activist, lawyer, even before I was elected to any office. I knew Ovi Duncantel and the work that he had done. I was excited about a man that was committed to everyone else but himself. Ovi Duncantel never utilized the Black Heritage Society for anyone but others, and he always was trying to empower others. With the Martin Luther King Parade, he empowered children, he empowered bands and colleges, he empowered different groups from all over the community, all over the state, frankly, to come to this outstanding celebration of Martin Luther King. And he made it a very special day. And it was a day filled with members of our community, African Americans, but it brought out a broad base of community because it was the one, it was the original and is the original Martin Luther King Day Parade.
We made a lifetime commitment to carry on the Dr. King's legacy. So it's deeply ingrained with me, and I know as long as I'm on this planet, there will be a Dr. Martin Luther King program honoring this great man.
In his iconic speech at the Lincoln Memorial for the 1963 March on Washington for Jobs and for Freedom, Dr. King urged America to make real the promises of democracy. He spoke of a dream, and we at the Salvation Army still share in that dream, which was talked about some 57 years ago. And the truth is, we desire to fight for that dream to become a reality. For you see, we still refuse to believe that the Bank of Justice is bankrupt. We still refuse to believe that there are insufficient funds in the great vaults of opportunity of this nation. And so we continue to try. We try to cash a check that will give us upon demand the riches of freedom and the security of justice. We at the Salvation Army, we join with Dr. King in the fact that we still have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. The creed that says we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men, all, are created equal. We still hold to that dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, every hill and every mountain shall be made low. The rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places, they will be made straight. And that the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together. We at the Salvation Army, we still join in that dream that one day children, men, women, we will all live in a nation where we are not judged by the color of our skin, but by the content of our character. The Salvation Army counts itself as a part of this dream, and we commit to fight for the good for all people. Thank you, Dr. Martin Luther King, for your dream, for your work, for your ministry. May we all remember you, not just with our words, but may we do so in our actions, making that dream a reality.
Now, certainly there are many things that we must do for ourselves, and that only we can do for ourselves.
Certainly, we must develop within a sense of dignity and self-respect that nobody else can give us.
A sense of manhood.
A sense of personhood. A sense of not being ashamed of our heritage.
Not being ashamed of our color.
It was wrong and tragic of the Negro ever to allow himself to be ashamed of the fact that he was black, or ashamed of the fact that his ancestral home was Africa.
And so there's a great deal that the Negro can do to develop self-respect.
There is a great deal that the Negro must do and can do to
amass political and economic power,
defend his own community, and by using his own resources.
And so we must do certain things for ourselves, but this must not negate the fact
and cause the nation to overlook the fact that the Negro cannot solve the problem by himself.
My name is Deloitte Parker, and I'm Executive Director of SHAPE Community Center. And we're speaking about Dr. King right now. First of all, celebrating Dr. King's legacy, his life, is important to me. It's personal to me. I was in Houston when Dr. King came to Houston to speak out against the Vietnam War at the downtown Houston. And a smoke bomb went off in the Coliseum. And we had to run out. I was there giving out tickets to go see Dr. King. Lena Horne was there. And many other people were there. Aretha Franklin was there. I remember that. And I remember how we had to run out of that place after somebody viciously put a smoke bomb in there. But we didn't stop because we continued to meet. So celebrating his legacy, is personal to me. So I stand up, I lift up all those people who understand the role that Dr. King played in the history, in our future, in our history, in our lives, period. So, and then of course, Dr. King, every year we take the children on the Freedom Tour at SHAPE Center. And one of the places we stop is Dexter Avenue Baptist Church, where King preached at. We stop there, and we stand in the pulpit that Dr. King preached out of. You know, so we had a personal relationship in a strange kind of way with Dr. King. I saw him in person, downtown Houston, when the smoke bomb went off, and we stood in his pulpit at Dexter Avenue Baptist Church where he preached at. So it's a personal thing with us, with SHAPE Community Center. So on behalf of SHAPE Community Center, we lift up his spirit, but more importantly, we recognize the role that he played in our liberation, but we're still not there. I'm sure he's saying to us right now, the struggle continues.
Hey, H-Town, we are still out here rocking at McGregor Park. Right now, I want to bring in one of Houston's at-large city council members, Mr. David Robinson. Good morning. How's it going?
Great, Paige. Great to be with you. Great to be in McGregor Park in Houston.
Absolutely. It's just a beautiful day outside, isn't it?
Absolutely gorgeous. Another day in paradise in Houston, Texas.
A great day to give back on this MLK Day.
You're right about that.
For sure. Now let's talk about the importance of service and giving back in the community. What does it mean to you?
Well, in a normal year, this would be about celebrating Dr. King's legacy with a parade. In this case, it would be downtown, but with COVID, with social distancing and the importance of giving back in the spirit of Dr. King, we're here in McGregor Park where people can bring by dry goods, food, packaged items, and give back to the community. And it seems like a very fitting way to celebrate the legacy of Dr. King.
Absolutely. It's such a good turnout out here right now. We have folks coming through the lines, donations being made. How do you think it's important to remember Dr. King's legacy and still give back despite the challenges that are going on around us with the pandemic?
Well, I think of Dr. King as that emotional leader and that champion for justice in our country's history that just means so much in this really critical time for our country and in this city, in a place where Dr. King had a very significant presence. And that is today more important than ever. And I believe that right here we can feel it very tangibly, and we've got people coming out to show the love. It's a great day for Houston and for Dr. King.
Absolutely. What's your favorite thing about the parade and giving back, even though things are a little different this year?
Well, it's always fun to be out with Mayor Sylvester Turner. We're also here with my colleague, Sally Alcorn, and the director of the Parks Department, Kenneth Allen. So we're here celebrating the park, but we're being smart about social distancing. But the folks who are coming with a real generous spirit of giving back. And so we're helping. We're doing some of the lines to transfer goods and make sure that they're getting to the right places. And Mayor Turner, I think, has put it really well, and again, in the spirit of Dr. King, to celebrate his legacy, think about his legacy of nonviolent promotion of justice in our country. And you know, that just means so much to me today personally, and for all of the residents of Houston that I represent.
Very well said, Councilmember Robinson. Now, for those folks who couldn't come out here today, what do you think are some good ways that they can still give back and pour into their communities?
Well, I think it's important to be able to give in the form of the donations that are being brought out here today. I've handled packages of socks, toothbrushes, canned goods, diapers, formula, things for babies and infants, families, people who are hungry. There's no lack of ways that you can give back. And right here in McGregor Park is the best place that I know that you can drop them off. But of course, our institutions and our churches throughout the city are great destinations. So, you know, call my office, call the city, find out ways that you can give back. But again, in Dr. King's honor, let's give back.
Very good. Thank you so much for your time. That's all the time that we have for right now. Again, we're going to keep checking back in with you all as the parade continues on. So make sure you stay tuned with us right here at McGregor Park.
Amazing. Thank you to everyone who took the time out to drive through and donate at the Parade of Giving at McGregor Park today. Your generosity will help so many families in need during these times. For those of you who didn't know, many years ago, the Black Heritage Society was responsible for naming the Houston MLK Jr. Memorial Plaza at McGregor Park. So this is a full circle moment for the organization as we honor the life and legacy of Dr. King and embody his spirit of selflessness.
Now, up next, you'll see footage all the way from Oklahoma, the Langston University Marching Pride, the Harris County Democrats, along with more past parade footage, including Prairie View University's Marching Storm.
We started here working on programs that enhanced Dr. King's energy and life in 1975 when I organized the Black Heritage Society. As you know, we went from the organization called the Central Committee for the Protection of Poor People to the Black Heritage Society. But when we became the Black Heritage Society, we had to take on a project. The project we decided to take on was to enhance and give keep alive Dr. King's image, name, and reputation.
My name is Jonathan Allen, Assistant Director of Bands here at Langston University. On behalf of Mark Gordon, Director of Bands, and Dr. Kent Smith, President, we want to wish you a happy 43rd annual MLK Day hosted by the great city of Houston and the Black Heritage Society. L's up. Thank you.
Thank you, Harris County, for your commitment to progress.
For your support of human rights.
For your desire to work to realize the dreams of Martin Luther King Jr. and other civil rights leaders.
On this MLK Day, we recognize the public service efforts of our team and the leaders throughout the community.
From coordinating voter registration drives at Mosque countywide to participating in the Lunar New Year Festival.
We work to expand our voter base to record high numbers.
We built relationships within our community by participating in local blood drives.
Hosting a pre-COVID Friendsgiving festival and introducing the many candidates for public office.
We supported our community by coordinating food distribution to help more than 500 families in need.
And together, we celebrated multiple LGBT milestones.
As well as events like iftar at the largest mosque in Houston.
As we commemorate MLK Day, we look forward to the positive changes our Democratic Party will bring to the community this year and in years to come. Thank you, Harris County.
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 Greetings. This is Student Regional Minister Dr. Abdul Halim Muhammad of Muhammad Mosque No. 45, the Nation of Islam, Houston, Texas. We salute the Black Heritage Society in its 43rd original Martin Luther King Day Parade. The Nation of Islam, under the leadership of the Honorable Louis Farrakhan, salutes Dr. King for his undying fight against the triple evils of racism, poverty, and militarism for which he gave his life. The way that we can honor Dr. King is by the City of Houston, community partners, and all of us who are concerned coming together to take care of the least, the last, the lost, the left behind, and the left out. We can do it by pooling our resources and coming together and doing the things that are necessary to bring comfort to our people during this pandemic and this economic downturn and during this time of racial reckoning and political gridlock. Together, in the City of Houston, we can lift each other up and honor Dr. King, not by parades alone, not by words alone, but by our deeds. We wish you a happy Dr. Martin Luther King Day. Assalamu alaikum.
Save our school!
In the brown hat.
Save our school!
Okay, H-Town, we are still out here rocking at McGregor Park. We've talked to politicians, organizations from some of the donations that we're collecting donations from. And right now we have Harris County Attorney Christian Menefee. Good morning. How are you?
I'm great. Super excited to be here. Thank you.
Absolutely. Now, in your capacity as an attorney, how do you serve your community?
You know, in many different ways. Before I got elected back in November and just came into office in January as the youngest and first Black Harris County attorney, I was in the private sector, but I spent my nights and my weekends serving my community by providing pro bono legal advice, by working on community boards and doing other community efforts. But I'm super excited to be in office now because my entire job is protecting the interests of the people of Harris County. So I see the entire job is serving people now.
Absolutely. And do you have an organization out here collecting donations, or are you just out here to represent and show love?
Well, I'm out here for a few reasons. One, to represent and show love. Two, to make my donation, which I did earlier today, to Bread of Life. And three, because I'm a neighbor. I live just 5 minutes from here, and on a lot of days, given the beauty of McGregor Park, I'm out here, and so it'd be no different today.
Absolutely. Now, this is a question I've been asking a lot of our guests. We can't ignore the fact that this is a pandemic. We're standing here socially distanced with masks on. Some people may feel a little apprehensive of coming out in crowds. So how would you encourage our Houstonians to still do their part and get out and donate, even if it's not physically coming here?
Yeah, sure. You know, I'd say do what you can from where you can. I think for folks like myself, extroverts, this has been an incredibly tough time being in the house for this amount of time. So having the opportunity to come out in a wide open space and stay socially distanced and impact change is important. But if you're not comfortable with that, you can impact from home. You can make donations online. You can join in and see what's going on and participate in the process from the comfort of your own home.
Absolutely. As they're wrapping us up, I do want to ask you, what is your favorite Martin Luther King Jr. quote, if you have one?
A threat to justice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. You know, the important thing about Martin Luther King was that his life was incredibly focused on service to others and not being afraid to sacrifice the important things in your life for the things you believe in. My parents served more than 30 years collectively in the Coast Guard, and my life has been dedicated to service as well. And I think that if we all think about what we can do for others and not for ourselves, we can make meaningful change in our communities.
Absolutely. Well said. That's all the time that we have with you right now. Thank you so much. We do want to bring in Mr. Gregory Polite, if we can change out those microphones. I hope I didn't say your last name incorrectly.
Polite.
Polite. Yes, yes, sir. So tell us, who do you represent today?
My name is Gregory Polite. I'm the president of the Houston Black Firefighters Association of the Houston Fire Department.
And what, how and why is it important for you to be out here today at the Parade of Giving?
It's important for us to be out here since our inception, since 1985. The Houston Black Firefighters has always engaged in the Martin Luther King Parade. And even in the time of COVID, we had to adjust and overcome barriers of how to make this work. And so we want to continue on with the tradition.
Absolutely. How do you think everything is going on today? I mean, people have just been constantly coming through. There's been a consistent flow of people. How do you think everything is going?
I think everything is going good. Martin Luther King was all about community and unity. And when you put the two together is what you have out here. Mm-hmm. So for me to see people collectively coming together, it's always a good sight.
Absolutely. And so just as I asked your colleague before you, what are some ways that folks can get involved and serve their community, even if it's not physically volunteering?
Take a page out of the Houston Black Firefighters book. We serve the community. We've been serving again since 85. And through toy drives, donations, back to school drives, clothing drives, just get involved. All right. It's as simple as that. Find your local voluntary source to get involved in and just get involved.
Very well said. Is there anything you want to speak to about the legacy as we honor Martin Luther King Jr.? Anything about that?
When I think about the legacy of Martin Luther King Jr., it just reminds me of where we are and how far we have to go. All right. He paved the way, and him and others, other civil leaders have paved the way to make this to where we and you and I are standing here today. And through that, I want to continue on with his legacy by doing my part.
Very good. I think that's all the time we have for right now. Thank you so much. We're going to go ahead and send it back to the studio. And again, if you all cannot come out here physically, there's no worries. There are other avenues that you can do to still do your part and give back. And remember, nothing is too small when you're helping those in need. So that's all for right now. Stay tuned for our next segment.
Welcome back. We love to see the cars keep rolling in to help others.
Now, before we take a look at more throwback footage, we got to take a moment to honor the life and legacy of Ovid Duckintel, the founder of the Black Heritage Society and the original MLK Day Parade.
During his time here on Earth, he had the foresight to start this organization, inviting the father of Dr. King, Reverend Martin Luther Daddy King, Senior, to serve as his parade's grand marshal and special guest.
Now, on that same day, a street dedication was established to change South Park Boulevard to what is now known in Houston as Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. Wow.
Now, yes, Houston has always been a city where activism is on display.
Yeah, and we're proud of the changes that have been made through the years to honor those before us. Now we'll take a look at May Creek High School cheerleaders, Royal High School marching sound machine, and more footage from past parades.
I am reminded that Ovid Duckintel, again, I will say it again, didn't do for self, but he did for others. I remember the fights that we had to advocate for others when the National Football League brought its championship game, Super Bowl game, to Houston. He wanted to have scholarships for young people. He wanted to make sure that there were business opportunities for people in the community. And he wanted to make sure that the presence of African American in sports was honored during that time frame. He always utilized the interaction with corporate Houston and corporate America to bring more resources back to the children in the community, more resources to enhance the Martin Luther King Parade. And I remember him insisting on that legacy. And of course, there was that special time of protecting the tree that he had planted in honor of Martin Luther King, and it was going to be disturbed by construction. And he refused to step away from that tree, refused for many people who did not understand that he was not going to let that tree that was so powerful, that had been given in honor of the King family, by the King family, to be able to show the connection of this honorable parade, this original parade, to the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King. I remember that he tied himself to the tree. He would not leave until we had orchestrated the right kind of response that was needed at that time. But the most importantly, I want everybody to know that Ovid Duckintel always did for others and not for self. You could never find him fighting for something for Ovid. You could always find him fighting for the community and the betterment of this state and this nation.
Well, as I understand, before I came to Houston, McGregor Park, blacks could only go into that park on what was one day a year. And I think I was doing Juneteenth or something. Well, I don't forgot whatever it was, but they couldn't even go into that park. Now, we practically own the park, so.
Thank you.
250 Gulf Freeway, Houston, Texas, 77017. Hi, this is James Davis, president of Gulf Gate Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, and Ram, and we've been in business for over 18 years. And for me, what Martin Luther King's birthday means to me is to be part of that legacy that he has created. The reason that I'm standing here right now is for equality. So that's what it means for Gulf Gate Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, and Ram to be one of the only African-American dealerships in the city. And because he fought for equality, that's why I'm still here. And that's why that day means so much, because that's what he fought for, equal rights for everyone.
Houston City Council Member Amy Peck. I hope you're enjoying the virtual parade. This very short video cannot properly express what the life and legacy of Martin Luther King means to me, but I hope his courage and strength are reminders to all of us in our daily lives to be better, more caring, and compassionate to everyone. His legacy lives on every time we treat each other with respect. Thank you, and I hope that we can have the parade in person next year.
Hello, Houston. My name is Tarsha Jackson, and I'm the newly elected City Council Rep for District B. I am honored to be here with you today, celebrating the life and the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. On this solemn day, I encourage each of you to continue fighting for Dr. King's dream of a world where everyone is given the rights and the freedom to live life to the fullest. Dr. King was right when he said that the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. So it's up to each of us to continue Dr. King's fight for equality for everyone. In the end, truth, love, and justice will prevail. We all will prevail. So thank you and happy MLK Day.
Happy 92nd birthday, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I'm Vice Mayor Pro Tem Martha Castex Tatum. As we celebrate you today, it is my sincere hope that your message of love and action will resonate in the hearts of all Americans as we continue to build, work towards, and serve in our beloved communities. Let's all keep the dream alive.
During my very first job interview, I was asked, who would you most like to meet in the world?
Living or dead? Without hesitation, I said Martin Luther King Jr., and I'm sure I'd give that same answer again today. Martin Luther King Jr. fought for peace, fairness, and equality. His fight is not over. Throughout this last year, as the United States reckoned with a history of inequity never set right, Dr. King's words continue to be a beacon for the path forward.
The life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. is something that lives within all of us. So we must remember that an injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere, that we should try to conquer hate with love and stand up in the face of intolerance with tolerance. So on this MLK holiday weekend, we should take some time to reflect and see what we can do to make sure that his dream one day becomes a reality. God bless you all.
Welcome back, Houstonians. It's Paige Hubbard here, and we have just a little under 30 minutes left in our program. Right now, I want to bring in Congressman Al Green, who's going to join us and tell us what this day means to him. Good morning, Congressman. How's it going?
Good morning, Paige. Things are better than I deserve. I have been blessed. Thank you.
Very good. It's such a beautiful day out here.
It's a great day for a parade, especially this parade, when we honor and celebrate the life of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. He was what I call a prince for peaceful, nonviolent protest. He was the person that taught us how to make change in a very peaceful way, such that it would be a lasting change. Dr. King has given us reason to be here today. And I would also mention another person who has helped us to celebrate this occasion, Ovid Duncantale. As you know, he has been a part of this since the inception, and he has brought Martin King, the son of Dr. King, to this city for this event. And I want to thank the Heritage Society, the Black Heritage Society, for what it has done to make this possible. And I want to leave a few simple words. First, Dr. King reminded us that we must learn to live together. And this is especially important now because of all that's happened in Washington, D.C., all that's happened on planes as people are trying to traverse the country. He said we have to learn to live together as brothers and sisters, meaning as family. We are one family on this planet that we call Earth. One family. We must learn to live together as brothers and sisters, as family, or, he said, we will perish together as fools. We want to assure ourselves and posterity that we will not allow our differences to become the end of our being. We cannot allow our differences to destroy us. It's time for us to reach out to each other in the name of Dr. King, the prince of peaceful nonviolent protest, and let's resolve any differences that we have in a peaceful way. This is a time in our country when the call for peace is most appropriate, and this day makes it especially appropriate because of what he stood for. I'm honored to be here with you.
Very well said. You dropped some really good nuggets there. And a part of Dr. Martin Luther King's legacy was service. And we know a part of your personal and professional legacy aligns with service as well. So let's talk about the importance of giving back to our communities, especially those underdeserved and underprivileged communities.
Yes, service is important. Those of us who are blessed, we are blessed for one reason, and that is so that we may be a blessing to others. We are not blessed so that we can just enjoy the good life and not share it with others. We're not blessed so that we can develop a philosophy of live and let live. That's not the philosophy. The philosophy that we should adhere to is live and help live. If we have something that we can share and that will benefit others, that's what giving is about. We want to make sure that we who have the opportunity to live and the upper levels of life, that we remember those who are not as fortunate as we, and we want to bring them up and not in any way see them stay down. So service is important. But what is service? Service is being a part of community-based organizations. Service is supporting the Black Heritage Society. Service is being a volunteer at the Veterans Hospital to say to people, we know that you've been harmed and we care about you. Service is about going out into the community and making sure that people get registered to vote. Service is about doing that which is good where you are, whenever you can so that you can make a difference.
Very well said, Congressman Al Green. I hope our viewers caught all of those good nuggets. We want to thank you for your time and bring in Mr. James Harris with HEB. Thank you so much
and
for
I'm
your kind
honored.
Words.
I'm honored to pass the mic to a greater person.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
They're going to have a quick little photo op right now, but as Congressman Al Green just said, no service is too big or too small when you want to give back. We're now going to speak to Mr. James Harris with HEB. Good morning. How
good
you doing?
Good morning. How are you?
Good, good. So tell the folks, what do you do at HEB? What's your title?
So I'm Director of Diversity and Inclusion and Supplier Diversity. In lay terms, it means that I help the company with cultural celebrations, community outreach, and what have you. In addition to that, I help small local minority suppliers have an opportunity with our procurement teams with HEB.
So you do quite a bit in the community when it comes to giving back.
Yes, I do.
We know that you HEB donated money to HABJ for
yes.
its scholarship.
Yes.
So talk to us about what motivates your heart to give back to the people.
Well, you know, I think HEB has been in the space of giving back to the community for such a long time. And it really helps set us up for a recent campaign that we're about to launch called Be the Change. In fact, it launched back in June of last year. And Be the Change has many pillars, but specifically around community. It's about equality and equity in social, political forums for the community. For voter registration, police reform, criminal justice reform, and it's about equity in the community and social impact.
Would you say service could go far beyond just donating or giving items? Service can also be empowering minds and giving people the tools to better equip themselves so they can have a better quality of life.
That's exactly right. In fact, it's just much more than just, as you said so eloquently, just giving back, but it's actual empowerment, economic impact. And the economic impact has so many ramifications. When you do business with a community partner and they're helping others, everyone is healthier and we are better together than we are apart. And it's really about how can you bring together those collective parts to get to a healthy community. You have to have jobs, you have to education, equity, social impact. So all those things are critically important to having a healthy community. And HEB is about having the community healthier after having us been there as opposed to not.
Absolutely. There's knowledge and power, and there is power in numbers, that's
yes.
for sure.
Yes.
So as we're out here honoring the legacy of the great Martin Luther King Jr., talk to us about what his legacy means to you.
Well, you know, I think that Dr. King's legacy means servant leadership.
Mm-hmm.
And servant leadership doesn't mean standing idly by, but it's actually actively engaging and making a difference in others' lives. Most of the work that he did, from what I can have read up on and can remember, is not about helping himself. Is about helping others. And that's really about why we're here on today. How can we make a difference in the lives of others? You know, I'm reminded of this quote where Dr. King said that we may have come over on different ships, but we're in the same boat now. Which means that if I have a hole in my boat, we all go down together. So it is to our detriment if we work against each other. And it's to our benefit if we work together.
Absolutely. Teamwork makes the dream work.
It sure does. Thank you.
All righty. That's a good spot to end the interview. Now we're going to hear some remarks from our esteemed council members. And after that, you'll hear from Jay Mack and Keisha Nicole in the studio. Stay tuned.
So we're almost to the finish line, but we have a few more entries, okay? Including the University of Houston Cougar Marching Band. Now, J-Mac, did you know our Grand Marshal, Mayor Turner, is a UH Coug?
I did.
Okay, well, we love our local universities and can't wait to see all of our bands in person next year downtown.
Thank you.
Greetings. This is your brother, Kofi Tahaka. I have the privilege, the honor, and the responsibility of being the national chairman of the National Black United Front. We bring greetings to the 43rd annual original Martin Luther King Day parade here in Houston. We come in the spirit of the founder of the Black Heritage Society, our brother, Ovid Duncan Tell. The National Black United Front says that we must look at Dr. Martin Luther King in depth. We must not fall into the trap of vulgar individualism that is put forth when it comes to his legacy, that we must understand he was a part of an organization, the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, that was part and parcel of a broader organization with many different formations and factions within it in the 1960s era that helped to lay the foundation for the work that we are doing today. Please, brothers and sisters, look at his last writings, look at his evolution and transition in his philosophy and outlook. Look at the book, Where Do We Go From Here? Chaos or Community. Look at his last speeches where he talks about the triple evils of society, racism, poverty, and militarism. It is a must to honor his legacy appropriately, to study him and his contributions and his organizations and the broader movement properly. The National Black United Front is building on that legacy in any number of ways, including our Feed the Hood project, our Kole Sankofa Garden, our humanitarian aid, and last but not least, our frontline social justice activism. We salute you for working so hard for all of these years to keep the original MLK Day parade alive and well. In the National Black United Front, we say, forward ever, backwards never.
Welcome back, Houston. We are winding down our program, and we saved the best for last. Right now, I am joined by Mr. Sylvester Brown, the executive director of the Parade of Giving and also a board member. But before we get to her, let's speak to Mr. Brown about today's event. And how do you feel seeing all of your hard work finally coming full circle?
Well, as usual, we're always excited. Third Monday in every year, we celebrate the legacy of Dr. King. I'm just so excited that we were able to put on a program that would allow people, the entire community, to galvanize, to come out and give, okay? Due to the pandemic, okay, a lot of people are suffering. And I thought today would be a day. This is our 43rd consecutive year. We've never missed a year. We started this parade January 21st of 1975, it was commissioned by Dr. King's father, Daddy King. And we've held the parade ever since, rain, shine, sleet, or snow, over at Duncantel, who is our late founder of this organization. Started this parade again January 21st of 1978. Dr. King's father was the commissioner of the parade, but he was the grand marshal as well. So that was 5 years. Before the legislation was passed. The legislation was not passed, the holiday, until 1983. And we started in 1978.
Wow.
So we're excited to continue the legacy of Houston original MLK parade. And we're just so excited about it. I have my one of my board members here, Mrs. Thelma Scott, who is one of the directors. And of course, I look forward to their participation. We have several other board members, Helen Johnson, Teresa Brewer, that's not here today, but I just wanted to acknowledge them as board members as well, along with the Ms. Scott here, Thelma Scott here, who's been a board member for some time.
Absolutely. Now let's bring in Mrs. Scott. Good morning. How you doing?
I'm doing wonderful today.
That's good. Now, as Mr. Brown just said, this has been going on for decades.
Yes.
And the pandemic has changed things, just as it's changed a lot of things going on in our world right now.
Yes.
So was it ever a thought to you all that y'all weren't going to have this celebration, or were y'all were like, no, we're going to keep this going?
No, it was never a thought in my mind, because if you know Mr. Sylvester Brown, he don't never stop. He's continuing to make it work. And I know that it was going to be something going on this day, to honor Dr. Martin Luther King, and also to honor Mr. Obi Duncantel, who is the founder.
Absolutely. Now, as a board member of this organization, how important do you feel like it is to continue to have these events, to spread knowledge about Dr. Martin Luther King's legacy, and continue to have awareness about his life here in Houston?
Well, it's so important to keep the fight and never give up, because he was a man that never gave up. And this was his dream. So, and it's a dream of Sylvester's, Mr. Obi Duncantel, keep it going. So I don't have to worry, because I know Sylvester's going to keep it going no matter what.
Absolutely.
I wasn't planning on coming today, because I'm a senior citizen and I stay at home. But he said just to come out and see what's going on. So I came out to make my donation of giving, because that's what it's about. But I'm so honored to be here, and I just want to commend the other board members that's not here today, all of them, to keep this legacy alive and know that Sylvester is doing a fantastic job. So we want to take our hats off to him for doing a fantastic job getting this all together. Most a lot of it he does by himself. I have to give him that credit. Mm-hmm. All right. But I thank him so much for the beautiful work that he does and keeping the Dr. Martin Luther King dream alive.
Absolutely. Is there any more comments or remarks you all want to share about this day, just about the resiliency, just how Martin Luther King Jr. had to be resilient through his life, and you all had to be resilient through planning this parade in the middle of a pandemic in which we are socially distanced, wearing masks? Any last remarks before we turn it over?
Well, you know, the country is facing a pandemic, or we're facing, we're trying to reckon with a situation that no one even could imagine. And I think when we look back at the words of Dr. King, where do we go from here? Okay, as well we are right now in this country. There's a lot of things that have been seen that need to be seen in order to realize that we still face many of the same problems that we faced 53 years ago when Dr. King spoke about justice and equality. So I am just hopeful that what we're seeing right now reminds us all that we may have all come from different places, but we're all in the same boat now. You know, and I'm looking forward and hoping, okay, that this country would reconcile the problems that we've had and the challenges that we've had in the past to come to realize that there's something that we have to do as a community.
Coming together.
Yes, coming together.
Absolutely. Yes. It's all about teamwork. Well, we want to thank you all for your time and allowing me to be a part of this amazing organization and event as we're standing in front of his statue here. I know he's looking down, shining bright, yes, smiling on all of the hard work you all are doing. So thank you all so much. Now we would like to bring in a representative from Rodney Ellis's office who was going to present us with a proclamation. Can we have your first and last name, please?
Yes, my name is Adidiong Obote. I'm representing Commissioner Rodney Ellis. And on behalf of Commissioner Rodney Ellis, Harris County Precinct 1, we would like to present this certificate and resolution to Mr. Sylvester Brown as the founder of Black Heritage Society and also the executive director for the parade, and in recognition of your organizational efforts for the 43rd annual original MLK Day parade and holiday celebration. We want to recognize you for maintaining the tradition and safety of this holiday, as well as this event during the time of a pandemic. And also we want to say thank you again for hosting this. The parade of giving, I believe, is the first time y'all have done that. So we want to recognize your efforts. We know that people are in need as well.
See, Ms. Scott, you weren't even going to come today, and you got a proclamation. How does that feel?
I know it. I just feel so honored to be here and just honored to be a part of the MLK board and knowing that this is going to continue. And I can guarantee you that, because this is going to never fail. No matter what the cause is, the MLK Foundation Parade will continue throughout the years.
Amen. From your lips to God's ears. Any remarks from you, Mr. Brown?
Yes, I want to thank Commissioner Ellis. Commissioner Ellis has been a supporter of the Black Heritage Society for many, many, many years. And we are just so thankful that we have public servants as we have in Commissioner Ellis to support organizations such as ours. Okay, we continue to look forward to community support. We look forward to next year would be our 44th, and we're excited.
Absolutely. I'm excited for you all. And again, congratulations on the proclamation and everything that you're doing here in the community. Do we still have a little bit more time or we're going to wrap it up? Okay, we're going to close out our program now. I want to thank everybody for tuning in with us today. And as we leave, I would like to leave you all with one of my greatest Martin Luther King quotes is, "Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. And hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that." So as we venture off into our lives and go into society, may today's remarks stay with you, as we heard some really good remarks from politicians and event organizers, that is. And again, we want to thank you all so much for tuning in with us, and you all have a great day. Paige Hubbard signing off.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for joining us. And special thanks to all of our parade sponsors like HTV, Houston Media Source, Timmy Chan's Restaurant, Citgo, Houston Society Change, Moss 45, Carl's Org, and Gulfgate Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, and Ram.
Now, don't forget to tag us in your post today at Original MLK Parade. We want to be back
yes.
to be your sponsors and your hosts next year.
Yes, we're so proud to return again.
You think they're going to do this virtual next year?
Sponsor, I hope not.
But if they do,
yes,
we're going to be the host.
Yes, we're going to be the host, and we can't wait to see you. All right, and don't forget to listen to us weekdays at 5 a.m. to 10 a.m. on 97.9 The Box.
Good morning, H-Town. I'm J-Mac.
And I'm Keisha. Hey, bye.